I'm going to go to start. I'm going to type in ISE and let's right click. And I'm going to run it as an administrator. I love PowerShell. And I will provide the commands for you guys if you need to configure this within your environment. Bam. Hopefully, you guys are able to hear me and see me. So, same command, right? We're using the PowerShell commandlet add DHCP server v4 class. V4 is IPv4. We're using the parameter of name. We're giving it this name. As you see on line 1, 3, and 5, we're using the same command, same parameters. The name is going to change. We're going to use another parameter of type. All three of them are going to use vendor. We're going to use another parameter of, or switch, whichever one you want to call it, switch or parameter, of data. And data, open and close quotations, are going to be this. Now, for 64-bit, it's going to be arch 00007. For 86-bit, the arch number would be 00006. And then for BIOS, 86-bit or 32-bit, 64, it will be off 00005 times. I'm going to highlight all three of them and I'm just going to run it and you're done, right? So let's go over what we're going to be doing right now. So right now we're going to be creating the policies for our DHCP server. So we're going to be using all three commands. 1, 3, and 5 is basically the same thing. The only thing that's going to change is the name and the condition. So for the first command, we're going to use the command of add DHCP server v4 policy with a switch of name. We're going to give it this name. The same thing with the 3 and 5. These are the names. For the scope, I'm hitting the same scope, 132.0. The condition is going to be an OR for all three. The vendor class is going to equal, again, it's going to change up a little bit. It's going to be Pixie Client UEFI 64 with the asterisk at the end. The second one is going to be 86, and the last one is going to be BIOS x86 and x64. Control A, and then let's run it. Done. Okay, so these are the commands. Let's go over them before we run it. And for all three of them, 1, 3, and 5, we're going to use the command of set DHCP server v4 option value. For all three of them, we're going to be using the switch of scope ID. The scope ID is basically your scope. 132.0 is what I'm going to do. The policy name, whatever name you provide it, make sure you change it. If you just want to be super lazy, the PowerShell script that I give you, hey, you could just use what I've used. Just make sure you change the scope ID. Make life easy for you. We're going to be using a switch of option ID. And it's going to be 066. You have don't be slick and do 66. Make sure you say 066. A switch of value and the IP address. Done. That's it. All right, so let's zoom out of here. We're going to do a Control A to select all of them. We're going to run and done. So for this one, again, we are going to use the same command that we use for setting up option 66. And you are able to do option 60 the same way. And I'm going to show you how to do option 60 if you guys need to do that. So we're going to use the same command, which is set DHCP server v4 option value. All three of them are going to be using the same switch. You're able to change your scope. For me, I'm using 132.0. Same command, I mean, same switch policy name. Got to make sure whatever policy name you provided in your end, because you probably don't want to use what I'm using. But I think this is pretty standard. Make sure you type it here within the open and close quotations. We're using the option ID switch. Make sure you put 067. Don't put 67, 067. We're going to use a switch of value for all three of them. And then this is where it's going to change for all three of them. Highlight everything. I like to like type everything up and make sure everything is written properly. And let's run this. Zoom in real quick, boom, option ID is gonna change. It's gonna change to 60, right? And this is not gonna work for me because I don't have option 60 to set up, but this is how you would configure it. Boom, so you did option ID for the switch, 060. Make sure you keep that zero. Don't get slick and put 60. Now for the value, let's erase this. The value is gonna be Pixie, all caps with a capital C, client. Done. Let's copy this. Let's highlight this. Delete, paste. And delete, paste. That's it, done.